In this video, I am going to explain why you should do treatment around sacrum. I sometimes do myofascial release around sacrum. Why? Reason is simple. Because there are many muscles around sacrum. Here is sacrum. Sacrum is triangular shaped bone. On lateral part of sacrum, mainly there are hip muscles and pelvic floor muscles. On lateral part, hip muscles and pelvic floor muscles. Let's say, but here, you don't see this muscle, there is gluteus maximus. Yep, gluteus maximus attaches to sacrum. By the way, gluteus maximus also attaches to pelvis. What can I say? So, I say gluteus maximus crosses sacroiliac joint. It's joint between sacrum and pelvis. This joint is considered very important for low back pain. It moves very tiny, it's very subtle. So, gluteus maximus crosses sacroiliac joint. Tightness of gluteus maximus may be one cause for low back pain. It's very important. Anyhow, gluteus maximus attaches to sacrum. Let's see this one. This is piriformis. Piriformis that attaches to kind of lateral part of sacrum, and also it attaches to anterior part. I will show you from different angle later. Piriformis is here, and few pelvic floor muscles also attach to anterior part, such as this one. This is coccygeus. Coccygeus. I will show you this muscle from different angle later as well. See that? Gluteus maximus, piriformis, and coccygeus, and a few more pelvic floor muscles. They attach to lateral part of sacrum. If you know myofascial release or any kind of massage technique, you should approach lateral part. Then you can access to many muscles simultaneously. Say you approach to here. You have chance to approach to gluteus maximus and piriformis same time. Right? Again, on lateral part, hip muscles and few pelvic floor muscles around here. Now then, what about top part? What kind of muscles are around top part and kind of superior part? There are many back muscles, such as these muscles. These muscles are erector spinae. Erector spinae, it's important for back extension and posture maintenance, right? Erector spinae. Deep to erector spinae, there are a few more muscles. You don't see that. Such as multifidus. Multifidus is important for spine stabilization. If multifidus gets tight, there's high chance to have low back pain. Erector spinae, multifidus, these are back muscles, right? And one more big muscle, which you don't see, it's like this. This green color represents latissimus dorsi. Latissimus dorsi. It's on back side, however, it is shoulder muscle. This is very rare muscle. It originates from pelvis and sacrum via myofascia. Okay, via myofascia. Muscle fiber of latissimus dorsi doesn't attach to pelvis, but via myofascia. Anyhow, latissimus dorsi is on pelvis and sacrum, then it goes to shoulder. It's very rare muscle. See that? On superior part, back muscles and shoulder muscles attaching around here. What about lateral part? Do you remember that? hip muscles and pelvic floor muscles. Then I want to add one more structure, that is connective tissue. I want to focus on this one. This is sacrotibialis ligament. Sacrotibialis ligament. This ligament connects sacrum and ischial tuberosity, which is part of ischium. It's very strong and thin. It's very strong and thick ligament. So when this ligament gets tight or maybe loosened, that affects to mobility of sacrum. Very important. One more interesting about sacrotibialis ligament. Hamstrings actually attach to sacrotibialis ligament. Huh, that's very interesting. If hamstrings get tight, this tightness can go to sacrotibialis ligament, right? Plus, tightness of sacrotibialis ligament affects sacrum, of course, because they are all connected. This tightness can be from hamstrings, then it goes to sacrotibialis ligament, then it can go to sacrum. Knowing anatomy is very interesting. You can apply for many things. Sacrotibialis ligament. And there are many other ligaments, such as, let's say, this one. This is sacrospinous ligament. Sacrospinous ligament. That also attaches to sacrum and pelvis. See that? There are various ligaments around sacrum. If you approach to lateral part, maybe you have chance to approach to these ligaments, not only muscles. How important this area is. Freaking important, right? For next part, let's go to anterior view of sacrum. Then you see more clear relationship of piriformis and pelvic floor muscles. This is anterior view. Of course, this is sacrum. Which one is piriformis? This is it. Do you see this part? This is attachment of piriformis. It attaches around this area. It's, of course, anterior part, right? It's not on lateral part. If you know that, then if you know how to treat piriformis, actually, you are approaching to anterior part as well. It's impossible to dig your fingers through internal organs. It's so painful and it's almost impossible to palpate piriformis from anterior part. Instead, you can approach piriformis from posterior part. Then there's chance that you can access to anterior part via muscle. Does it make sense? So if you know how to approach to around sacrum, you have chance to access to pelvic floor and piriformis. Then this is what? This is coccygeus. You just saw that on first picture, right? This is coccygeus. This is one of pelvic floor muscle. This is pubococcygeus. Pubococcygeus, this attaches to sacrum. See, many muscles attach to anterior part of sacrum. Again, it's impossible to approach from anterior part, but you can approach from posterior part. If you apply pressure here, you have chance that your intention and your work may affect anterior part. It's very important to understand. In today's video, I explained why you should treat around sacrum. The reason is simple. There are many muscles around sacrum. On lateral part, hip muscles and pelvic floor muscles, plus few ligaments. On superior part, there are back muscles and latissimus dorsi. See that? It's freaking important place. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.